Yo, what's up? It's your girl, Not Asia, Barz and Real Talk, and I'm back with another video about the have and the have-nots. Oh my God. Now, last time I talked to y'all, I was telling y'all that the season was over because I didn't know they were going to show another episode. I thought that was the season finale. But as I was, searching my movie site, I came across the mid-season premiere. I'm like, what? So I click on it. I'm watching it. Yo. I told y'all that Veronica was going to blame Hannah for Malissa's death. I told y'all. Like, she just a crazy-ass chick, man. I just knew she was going to blame Hannah, even though it was all her fault. But let me ask y'all something. Do y'all really think that she was pregnant? They said she was 3 months, and I'm like, well, damn, wouldn't she have been further along? And I asked y'all in the last video, don't y'all remember when she was in the room with the hanger? And then she went into the bathroom. I was thinking she was giving herself an abortion because that's the way they used to do it back in the day. They used to take a hanger, stick it up in their body, hook it onto the baby, and slide the baby out. I know that's disgusting, y'all, but that's the way people would do home abortions when they didn't want their parents knowing they were pregnant and stuff like that around like the 80s, early 90s. So anyway, tell me if y'all think she was pregnant because it might come out that she wasn't. But anyway, let's keep it moving. Rest in peace to Malissa, you know what I mean? She was a sweet girl, a little crazy, but a sweet girl. And that's just messed up that she had to end her life over Veronica's craziness. Oh, and I'm sorry. Look at this picture, y'all. We gonna get to this. All right, so let's start off talking about Jeffrey and Justin. Oh, God. He is crazier than like one of them stalkerish type of females. Like, he's worse than a female, put it like that. Like, I know I said that before, but dude just keeps taking it to another level when it comes to like stalking and harassing. However, I'm starting to think Jeffrey likes it a little bit in some sick, twisted type of way. Like, he likes that control, maybe because he is used to it, you know, from his mother doing it his whole life. Yeah, I think he like it. What y'all think? Make sure y'all listen to my questions and type them as y'all listening. I want y'all answers. You know what I'm saying? How y'all feel? Y'all think Jeffrey like it? Let me know. And I wonder how Jeffrey is going to feel after he finds out that he lost his first and only child. Now, we all know that he treated Malissa like crap. You know what I'm saying? Like, he always was just disrespectful and ignorant to her because he's not attracted to females. So he always treated her bad. Now, I wonder if he's going to actually feel bad or cry or anything when he finds out that she's dead. Like, how is Jeffrey going to take that? Oh, my God. I just wonder if he's even going to care. All right, so let's talk about Candace. And I know I'm going pretty fast, y'all. I'm trying to learn how to slow down, but keep up with me. And also, y'all know y'all can always rewind it and hear it again. So, all right, Candace, she is really about her money. She really is. That is so crazy how she got a dude to go scare her mother. Like, she's sending this goon, this gangster, over to her mom's house to scare her into giving her back the money. That's just crazy, man. But you know what? I got a feeling Hannah's boyfriend is going to be there when that dude comes in there to scare Hannah. Do y'all remember in the beginning of the show when Hannah's boyfriend gave her a hug and said he was going to come back over later after he finished handling his business? Yeah. So just because Benny is out the house, I think that her dude is going to be there. And that's when Hannah going to find out what kind of thug she really dealing with. Because, you know, Hannah's boyfriend has been hiding his past from her. You know, the fact that Veronica got him out of jail and the things, you know, he was a gangster. And Hannah is such a righteous woman, so it's crazy because she gonna, if that dude run up in there while her boyfriend there, I don't see him acting like no sucker. So she gonna find out some things, okay? That's just what I think. All right, and Benny, I think that when Benny finds out that Candace set up their mother, that's gonna be his breaking point. Because you know he takes up for Candace so much, to the point it's disturbing, like, sometimes. Like, he always taking up for Candace, but he loves the hell out of his mother. More than his sister, I believe. You know what I mean? So when he find out, or if he find out, oh, that's going to be crazy. That might be the time that Benny cuts Candace off, you know? Now, the fact that Hannah is so righteous, I'm like, damn, Candace didn't think about, you know, if her mother finds out, she's going to go give that money back. Candace sent that dude over there, she's going to in the next show. Send that guy over there not knowing that Hannah already told the criers that she has their money and she's going to return it. Oh, my God. That's going to be crazy. Candace, Oh, that's another thing. Candace sicked Gia. She sicked Gia on Benny because she wanted her to keep him occupied while she gets that dude over to her mom's house. What's crazy is Candace still doesn't know that Gia is working with the feds. You know, she does not know that she's an informant. She's going back telling them anything she could find out about Candace. So sicking her on her brother was the worst thing she could have did. They're getting drunk. They're about to have sex in the next episode, what I see from the preview anyway. And I believe this is going to be Gia's way of getting even more dirt on Candace to get her, you know, possibly locked up. Oh, man, that's crazy. Candace is a crazy-ass chick. We all know that. So Gia just better hope she don't slip up or Benny find out she working with the feds some type of way. She just better hope Candace don't find out. And Candace better make sure her brother don't start feeling Gia and opening up, spilling all the tea, you know? Oh, man. All right, what's next? Stuff is about to get real for the Criers because the mob knows that her son actually stabbed that mobster in the neck. Or sliced his neck. That's going to get crazy. You know, we all know that mob family is they do what the mob do. You feel me? So now that, what's his name? I can't get his name. Benny's friend. Now that his uncle has woke up and told him to go find out what the guy's name is. And the fact that they're in the same facility, the same hospital. I'm like, wait a minute. Y'all in the same building? Oh, this is about to get too real. Too real. Okay, so I'm gonna do something real corny right now, okay, y'all? Because this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Dun, dun, dun! Erika and David. Oh, my God. I know y'all keep seeing that picture pop up. That picture is terrible. Yo, when the episode came on and I saw the car, like, with the steam coming from it, who had an idea that Erika would be that burnt? Like, we seen the explosion, but God damn. Oh my God. Just to show her like that with all her skin off, just like a burnt up skeleton. Like, you could see the patch of hair in the back, like a patch of her hair burnt to the back of the head. It's just, oh my God, that was crazy. Damn. That's all I can say. Like, I knew David was going to survive. We probably all knew that because he's a main character and he has to somehow get some type of revenge. Like, come on. Nobody thought David. I don't think anyone thought David would die. You know what I mean? But what is crazy is, imagine if he would have had his eyes open and saw Erika in that condition. Oh my God. That would have gave him a heart attack straight away. What y'all think? If he would have opened his eyes, see that, yo, that would have, look at this picture. Look at it. And this is probably the only channel that's going to give y'all some raw footage like this. I'm going to try my best to give y'all, you know, as much little pictures and things as I can. Because a lot of people tell me they be working and can't really watch the show and they appreciate my updates. Salute to you for listening to what I have to say. You feel me? But anyway, I wonder what the hell David is going to do. Oh, my God. I wonder what... Oh, man. Listen, this is the second female that David was in love with that Veronica killed. Y'all remember the Caucasian woman that he was in love with? And Veronica got her shot or whatever? Yo, like, how much more can he take? He might... Yo, I don't know. I don't have no idea. What y'all think David gonna do when he find out? If y'all remember my last recap, I said David gonna end up in a coma or just in a hospital severely burned. Didn't I say that? And I think for some reason, I could be wrong, but I think Jim is going to go see him and he probably going to ask Jim, where is Erika? Why am I seeing this like that? I don't know, but somebody going to have to explain to him what happened to Erika, and that's going to be crazy. Because, I mean, he's going to be so heartbroken. And then again, I'm sure it's going to come out, you know, what Erica's motives were. Like, he's going to find out she was using him and she was about to scam him and all that. You know, but guess what? I'm also sure he's not going to believe any of it because he was truly, madly, deeply in love with Erika. Like, when they look at each other, it just seemed like two teenagers in love for the first time, feeling butterflies. Like, I was starting to actually love their relationship. Shit. Erika was so good. She was probably having all of us fooled at some point, right? Like, but when I seen Erika get on the phone with, what the hell is that guy named that work at the bar? And she was telling him that she was going to get pregnant because this is a really good move for her. Then I was like, well, damn, she really is still, like, on that scamming shit. So what do y'all think? Was Erika falling in love Or was she falling in love with David genuinely? Or do y'all think she was just that good of a scammer? Let me know below about that, man. Do you guys think that she was just an expert at scamming? Or was she truly catching feelings for David? But anyway, the next episode looks like it's going to be dope as shit. And I will be back to talk to y'all about it. So far, the little clip that I seen has a man running in Hannah's house on a late night so he can scare her like Candace told him to. And what else did I see? I saw Gia on top of Benny in a hotel in a bed. I was like, ooh, Benny about to start telling all Candace business. I saw Jeffrey and his mother sitting at the bar together having a little meeting. I'm like, what is that about? Also, Veronica crazy ass was standing in the mirror pretending to have feelings at David's funeral. Like, she had a black dress in her hand and was like, oh, my husband. I was like, this chick crazy. She don't even know he survived. She's going to be so salty when she find out he survived. And the fact that they handle their own business and they don't go to the police when things happen, oh, you better believe David going to get her ass back. How he going to do it? I don't know. But let's talk about this in the comment section. Salute to everybody that rocks with my channel. Salute. I truly love y'all. Thank you so much for all the support. Thank you for listening to me. And also, let me know who watches the show called Power. And let me know if y'all would like to, you know, for me to do more recaps on Power. Because I love Power as well. All right, y'all. If you have not subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell. And salute to everyone who shares my videos. I looked into my YouTube account and I see that you guys been sharing. Thank you so much. All right, y'all. Mwah. Let's talk about it.